show. Hello there. Welcome to RenmanMusicAndBusiness.com. My name is Steve Rennie, and I am the Renman. And this little segment is called Ask Renman. Today we have a question from a gentleman by the name of Rick Pivetta. I'll read his question. It says, "Hi, Renman. My name is Rick, and my band and I have a full-length album with 12 songs to be released. We are thinking of releasing our first single on either November 11th or December 9th. Is both of these dates bad to release because of the holidays? Also, we are planning to release a second single before the album is out. How long should the space be between these two releases? What are the pointers to determine that? Thanks so much, so forth." Okay, a couple things to talk about here. First things first. When you're talking about releasing a single, I'm not quite sure what you mean, but let me explain. If you're working with a major label, or you're looking to get some big impact for a single, it's not just putting the single on TuneCore or iTunes or in somewhere out in the digital space. It's much more than that. That single would be accompanied by a video. It might be include an advertising buy, you know, to buy advertising around the web. It would likely include a plan to take that song to radio. It would likely include a touring element to it. It might include some retail positioning elements. That's what the big folks do when they're releasing a record. My guess is your idea of releasing a record is just putting it on TuneCore and so forth. And in that case, it probably doesn't matter when you release that single, right? But keep in mind that a proper release isn't just putting it in the distribution channels. It's finding a way to let everybody know it's there so that they can actually buy it. You ask, what's the proper time between singles? Well, that's not an easy answer, but I'll say this. The more successful the single is, gets on the radio, your video gets airplay, you know, it gets played in, you know, all kinds of different arenas, the more likely the success of the single, the second single would be. It might take a year for a single to fully develop. If you think about Imagine Dragons or The Lumineers is one that comes to mind where that song took about a year to fully flower. So how long in between singles? Get the first single right and then worry about the second single would be my advice. You hope that you don't go to the second single too soon, but it'll be all the same things we talked about at the top. There needs to be more than just releasing it out there. As far as Christmas goes, right, just know this. If you were a major label sitting around with a big-time artist, you want your record out there at Christmas. So all the big labels are spending money. They're buying slots on iTunes. They're all over the radio. Their artists are playing radio shows. And for that reason, most new developing artists at a big label would never get released at Christmas time. You take your shot at the top of the new year when there's a little bit less traffic out there. So hopefully that answers your question. I want to give you a couple videos to take a look at while you're out there. First thing we're going to do is there's one. I'm going to take you to our guest list here on our website. Let me show you where we are. And you click on that guest list button, it'll take you to a place. I'm going to take you to a gentleman by the name of Jack Hedges, who's a product manager at Canvasback Records. Here, let me just show you that. Jack Hedges can talk about the elements of a marketing plan. So I want you to check out Jack Hedges. All you got to do is scroll down to all the content. And number that second video, number two videos, he talks about building a marketing plan so that you'll understand what all those elements are that make up a proper single release. That's my answer there. I hope that helps you out, Rick. Keep putting that stuff out there, but get a little bit more of a plan together on it, and you'll have a much more successful single. I hope that helps you. Good luck out there. We'll see you soon.